This video starts off abruptly at the point I realized something very interesting was likely about to happen. I've been stalking a group of four coastal bandits for about 40 minutes at this point, and this is me having just moved to within meters of their position. I'll talk more about it in a bit, just watch for now. Oh, and note that this is a first-person only server. So let's talk about that and what just happened there. What I don't have, unfortunately, is the footage that led up to this. I'll spare you the details. Suffice it to say that I spent roughly 40 minutes stalking this group of seeming bandits around Komarovo. It took about that long for me to work my way close to them. With the numbers as they were, I figured my best chance would be to hit them up close and unaware. Each time I could see them moving, they did so in a careful and a deliberate manner. They moved from tree to tree, brush line to brush line, and they were clearly looking to ambush someone. The fact that I was able to maintain pace with them was testament to how carefully they'd move. Even as cautious as I was, I still made it up to them after some time. The video started right as I realized I was in the same brush line as them, and what happened next was a beautiful example of human perception. The obvious question is, how did they not see me? How could their whole group run right past me and not notice? The answer to that lies in expectations and prioritization of threats. They had no real reason to expect anyone in an area that just moved through seconds earlier. The bush that several of them passed around meant that they'd have a very limited window in which they might see me in the corner of their screen. The person that ran right past me almost certainly wasn't thinking that a bush he'd run past seconds earlier now might suddenly be threatening. From their perspective, they were the sneaky ones. They were the ambush. They knew what was in the area. They were wrong, but not in a glaring fashion. They made mistakes, but they weren't massive ones. They played carefully, they seemed to move intelligently for the most part, and they seemed patient. It's amazing how a person having their focus 100 meters to their front can cause a 2 or 3 second lapse of close-range observation, sufficient enough to hide a human form lying in the grass just in front of them, that those 2 or 3 seconds in an hour's time were sufficient to result in their death. Now, the point I'd like to make here is how significant this experience was from a first-person perspective. Each time I moved up, trying to close a gap with them, I knew there was a chance someone would see me, that someone would be covering their back and notice a movement in the trees behind them. I also knew that there was no way anyone would be able to exploit third person to observe me without me having a chance to see them myself. When they eventually ran past me at the start of the video, they all did so from a first person perspective, allowing them to miss something hidden in the grass, literally at their feet. I have no doubt that a third person POV would have revealed me there. I have no doubt that had they been using third person, they would have been much more likely to spot me earlier. They couldn't, and they didn't, because it wasn't allowed on the server, and that made all the difference. The rest of this video is me circling back around to check out the ambush site from a different direction. I wasn't really sure what effect it had on them. The recoil in DayZ is pretty awful. I suspect that I hadn't done as much damage as I might have otherwise. I'm sure it scared the hell out of them, though, and it was fun. I even got a souvenir in the end. If you've never played DayZ or Arma Adversarial on a server that's locked to first person, I'd highly recommend it. Anyone can win a fight when they're never seen because they're exploiting third person from a distance, looking over walls or around corners and whatever. But to close with and kill the enemy without that crutch to lean on, it's quite a different experience. I recommend at least trying it. It'll take you out of your comfort zone, but then again, isn't that kind of the point of DayZ? You be the judge. Give it a shot.